Here are two of the things you should get really good at once you start flying paramotors. The first thing that you want to get really, really good at, if you want to get good at flying paramotors, if you want to continue to progress, is oscillation control. In a very simple way, oscillation is the rocking back and forth of the wing. This is a very common thing. Some wings do it more than others. It is going to happen at all times of every flight. It's never not going to be there. The good pilots and the pilots that you see flying around on a regular basis that have experience, you will never notice them rock back and forth because they're really, really fast at correcting that oscillation instinctually. They don't even think about it. So that's the first thing that you want to get really, really good at is that oscillation. You never want to have uncontrolled oscillation. You never want to be rocking back and forth without being in control. So how exactly do you stop an oscillation? How do you identify an oscillation and why is it so important? Well, the first thing is if the wing is rocking left and right, you actually want to pull to the side that it's coming from. Meaning if it rocks down to the right, as it's coming above you, you're going to touch a little bit of right brake and put that hand back up before you pull it back down to the right. It is not the other way, as meaning it is not the, as it's dipping right, you pull left. That is actually going to enhance the oscillation. Now, this all being said, any good paramotor training is going to help you learn how to control that oscillation. But when you do leave training class, this needs to be a big priority. You want to make sure that you are never oscillating. That is never a problem and that it is never going on without you intending to or not paying attention. It just shouldn't happen. Get good at oscillation control. The second thing that you want to get really good at is throttle control. This is full throttle. This is maintaining throttle. This is smooth in and out of the power band. This is not jerky up, down, all around throttle control. You want to be smooth. You want to be controlled. You want to be precise. You want to be consistent. Now, why are these two things super, super important? Well, the natural progression of flying paramotors is you will come and play a little bit lower and a little bit lower, not necessarily low acro, but you're going to want to follow down that creek or that river or that farmer's field, maybe 10 feet, 15 feet instead of 500 feet, 300 feet. When you come down, if you have any oscillation, that oscillation can sway you down closer to the ground than you mean to. Now, this is something that happens more so on landing, but if you are swaying really low to the ground, it can bring you in sideways and set you down on the ground, which is not a pleasant situation. That is rare to happen. That doesn't happen often. It's more so a thing when you come into land, but it is a possibility. The other thing is that throttle control. If you are irky jerky or rough on that throttle and you bring yourself below that 50 feet minimum that I personally recommend for new pilots, you come down there and you're slow on that throttle, you're not consistent on that throttle, you're not smooth on that throttle, things happen really fast. You may not be fast enough to respond. Having control of that oscillation, having control of that throttle is just going to increase the safety that you will have as you come closer and closer to the ground. Now, everybody likes to talk about and say, never come below, you know, 50 feet, never play low to the ground. I think that's kind of bogus. I think that's kind of over exaggerated. The reality is we get into paramotoring to come down near the ground, to kiss the ground, to have that perspective, to be close, to foot drag, to play near the trees, the farmer fields, the haystacks. In an ideal world, yes, you would never come below 50 feet, 100 feet, but in the real world, you're going to want to. So as you start to itch yourself closer and closer to the ground, let's be realistic here and let's work on the things that are going to be important. Work on that throttle control, work on being smooth, work on being precise, work on being smooth and precise without paying attention to it. Work on that oscillation. Work on all of those things so that when you do enter below that 50 feet, which as you enter below that 50 feet, you need to be paying attention, you need to be sharp, and you need to be on your game. When you do step below that 50 feet minimum and you are starting to get a little closer to the ground, that you have control of those two things. My name is Trevor Steele. Thank you guys for watching. If you are interested in more information about our 10-day beginner training or 4-day advanced paramotor training where we can help you with this exact thing, please visit our website, backcountryppg.com. We appreciate your guys' support. We appreciate your business. Please like this video, and we will see you in the next video.